Yeehaw!
Alrighty, recording on. See if we can take all the right moves today. We're at Jimperding Brook, everybody. Haha. Yeah, it is right here. Jeez, okay. This is where we split yesterday and I went the right hand side, but that's not the right way. So we're gonna just go straight ahead, and then you got the rapids just here, like the gravelly chute. Dad said no issue with it. He said there's tons of space and all that. So, and then after here is where he turned over at the little chute and the side thing there, but not this one, the next one. Eddies. This is the little rapids thing where the S bend will come in on the left and then cut round to the right. Probably a few rocks are showing today, so have to. This is only possible in high water, yeah. Seat feels good. Only just enough water. Yeah, more momentum, I guess, is to keep going. Yeah, that one's got some gnarly bits that is just not fun. Alright, now we got Russell's Folly, the bit where he came out. The same as we did yesterday. Well, this is the last half of the TiTrees that we're doing today, people. Put in it halfway. So this will be the end of day one of the Avon descent. And you'll be quite tired. And having come 41 k's to the beginning and then another 7 k's, you would have come about 48 kilometers by the time you get to where we began today. Sun will be higher in the sky than now. But you'll be wanting to know the easiest way throughs, the easiest way through. That's exactly what we're going to take today, the easiest way. Have no mistakes. That sun angle is reflecting bad on the water now. Can't see a whole lot. Yeah, gravel. That's usually an island in the middle. I think this might be Boomerang Pool, yeah. Long boomerang shape. Okay. Marathon stroke. Slow down. Oh, muscles fully. Just gotta go straight down and then take the left-hand channel. Not left at the top like Dad thought. Yeah, that's definitely the way. Right, now it's pretty much plain sailing to Cobblers, to Leatherheads, yeah. Exactly, yeah. Yeah, 0.68 water level. I don't think it would be below this for the race. I think you can almost guarantee it'll be this or above. But I mean, if we get through today, I'd say almost 100% that we'll get through on race day. And of course, you're trying harder on race day too, so. So glad I moved my seat. I adjusted it back where it was and it's perfect now. No pain at all, and I thought it would be feeling wrong, you know, but nope, it's still feels the same. It's just painless. It still feels like it's in the same place at least. That's when I'll really know, that's right. But at least this paddle will be just long enough to find out. Yeah, only 9 minutes in so far, geez. I think Joel has the record of doing the TiTrees in under an hour from the orchard. Years ago, I tried to race him when I was fit and training all the time in the plastic boat. Well, I tried to do to better his time, you know. And I think I got like 1:15 was my best from the orchard. We don't go from the orchard anymore, so we can't compare. So you get more tired now. Yeah. Well, no, I think this is Boomerang Pool, yeah. But there's another pool and another pool and then the pool above Extracts, above Leatherheads. Yeah. Well, there's no pool right above Leatherheads. There's like a pool, and then you go into some tree areas, and then you come around the corner and you're at the rapids. But there's a pool just a little bit further above. Alright, that's 1.9 km from Jimperding, I guess. That could move, but it's probably a good marker for now. You know, on the Garmins, you can have a map display on your watch while you're going down the rapids, the river, and you can put icons on that display on the app on your phone. So I've got all of the major rapids, and I must put Cobblers Pool on there and Possils and all that too, so that I can just switch to that mode right now, and it will tell you what's within 300 meters of you. And so I can be knowledgeable again after forgetting where the rapids are. It's mainly just to know the distance to the finish. Exactly where it is. Ooh. We've got six ducks that are already being chased. Dad's gonna know we're coming. Well, some of them chase them all the way down the valley, and you think they are gonna get a bit lost. I think we're gonna go left here. That's the usual way. Yeah, it should be okay. Over to the right afterwards. Huh. Okay. Maybe this ain't where you guys want to go. Do you want to drag up and do the right channel? Yep. I think you'll always be able to get through. Just might not be the fastest way, but yeah, okay. The top of that right channel didn't look very good, did it? No easier. Yep. and you know that way now, so probably better off. Yeah, I feel like I went right yesterday and it was no good. Not the hardest thing to do, is it? Yeah. And you can slow down, of course, yeah. I want to take that right-hand entrance in the double if you have a choice, but it's not that hard. Yeah. I'm going to end up over here, so I think, yeah, that's definitely the good entrance. no biggie either way. The jump tree, okay. Slow down and we're gonna go under the tree on the right hand side. This is the low water thing you do. You got tons of time and you just catch it and then you head under and just slide on through. That's what we jumped yesterday. So you can get under, yeah, okay. That's a no worries one then. You'll either go under or over every time. Even in the double, you guys can do that. You'll just take it as slow as you can. There's enough room, there's no big turn. And if it's... Exactly, it's one or the other. You can jump that too if you really wanted to in the double, and I can easily jump that in a single, but you don't need to. That was where the old gauge was, right there. The TiTrees gauge. Got washed away years ago. Now we're in the pool above Leatherheads. There's just a few more little open channels and then basically the Leatherheads in like, I don't know, 2.5 k's or 1.5 k's. 2 k's-ish. I wasn't right here because the bank is different, but it was, I think it could have been this one, yeah. It might have been a little bit further down because I remember kind of trying to hold on after something and then going, oh no, I can't hold on. I think it was, yeah, a little bit further down maybe. There was no, yes, there was no sand where I got out, but it was similar to the bank. And there was no dead kangaroo like back there. Yep. Yeah, yeah. Yep. Well, there's one below Leatherheads. In the... Yep. We're close. Yeah, yeah. No rocks in the tea trees. Yep. That's right, yeah. That big one that we took the left-hand channel for just like at the very beginning, we never used to go there. That's a new way. Because I always go down the right and then watch people get stuck on those rocks and have to carry down the chute. And I'm thinking, haha, suckers. Something in the middle in front of us. Oh, no, that wasn't. Island or something, I guess. Submerged island. Yeah, maybe this is Boomerang Pool. The first one was a boomerang to the left, this is a boomerang to the right. Yeah, yeah, okay. Oh yes, it's a long one. Could have been right there. That is a tree. Aha, log. Yeah, log. Strange one. Must be a huge tree off to the left. bit of breeze. I won't have that earlier in the day. Yeah, round earth house. Is it? No, different house. Nope. Almost round earth house time. Yeah, right hand chute here. Dad knows this one. Yeah, easier turn here than the other one. Yeah, I think I went wrong way left last time. Yep, yeah. getting through there. Yeah, leatherheads! You get shushed around a lot there, don't you? Just keep the correct side of paddle in water and you can just move the boat a bit if you need to. Yeah, you don't need a lot of power down leatherheads, I think. You can easily bump down there with the rudder stroke in. That's probably your easiest place to get in the morning as well. You can go here. But here is going to be packed. This is where everybody gets in right here. I suppose it's okay. Sometimes that beach is underwater or steep, so it's no good, but that looks alright. So, yeah, a bit further upstream if you can't get in, but I'm sure there'll be plenty of space. There's nowhere near as many boats as there used to be. Should be definitely under an hour. We're going well, we're going fast. Suppose we are doing super shoot too, so a little bit more. Gauges for it doesn't mean anything. All right, so we're gonna cut left in the island and then just stay left and see if it's got enough water down the left hand channel all the way. I think that's by far the easiest. Is it? Well, this is the overhang logs, yeah, or the island, I guess. It's at the island we turned, yeah, we cut left. It was just around this corner here. It's gonna have a little look at the log and then cut left. Oh, another corner. Yeah, that's right. There's an additional log. water's piling up nicely on it. You could maybe jump it, but it's lower than yesterday. Yeah. And you'll see that there's a gap in the island coming up, and you could go back into the main one, and that's exactly where our little secret chute was on the right. So if it gets really shallow and really not away, then you cut back right again. But thinking. Almost lost my paddle. Yeah, all good, all good. You got another rock, another slow section just in front. Stay in this channel, yeah. Oh dear. You got through okay there? Enough water, just yeah. That's definitely. I mean, where I don't go where I went, but that's definitely the better of the two. So the option now, so we can cut back in here if we want to, or we can keep going down the left. I want to keep going down the left to see what it's like. Well, you've got that secret chute, so you're going to take that secret chute on the right then. We've got one more big log, we've got one more overhang log coming, that's the problem. So we're trying to avoid the overhang log by here. Yeah, because you know that secret chute on the right. Well, you remember that secret chute on the right, yeah? That's just, I think you can even see it just there. Yeah. But you only do that, oh, okay. Oh, yeah, no, we're good. There's a log here. Oh, wow, okay. It's not a big worry. Try and jump it if you want. You'll easily jump it in the middle. I like it. Alright, you're correct. You see the thing after here? Bad. You're quite right. Now I'll jump out and come out with you. Come back with you. I'll do the same. I agree. That's good. We needed to know that so that you didn't try it in the race. Alrighty, here we go. Yeehaw! Oh, wow, okay. Head back into the main one, yeah. Yeah, that's gonna be your... Oh, sorry. Right hand side. Yeah, there's no log here, the log's only on the other side. Bit of stuff under the water there, but you won't hit it. Alright, now a secret chute across here. Now, make note of the log halfway across the river here. Check that out. Good, downstream, yeah. You have to come back up like this and go upstream a bit. Don't try and go straight into it. Don't cut that corner, you'd say. That's the... And you can see that, can't you? So you'll know you can't jump that. If you can jump it or go under it, then yeah, great, sort of. Exactly. It was 0.4 when we went under, and we only just made it under. Correct. Yeah. We took this at 0.6 and it was still goable, so we got down to 0.6 and this is okay. But if it's 0.5, You don't lose a lot then, exactly. You're going so slowly anyway. And then another nice log at the exit. Geez, I didn't notice that log at the entrance last time. We must have been coming along side onto that and almost hitting it. Now a few more meander loops and then we're at the dead trees. Oh, very close. A couple of 100 meters, I reckon. Just a few meander loops, and then we got the dead trees as the next hard bit. It's gonna crash through the right here. It's pretty narrow, but it's the only way. Just watch that one on the left, try and avoid it. It's a nice one. Yeah, well, that big one that won't be moving if you hit it. I think we're pretty much open until the dead trees now. Yeah, all the water's going down this way. You'll see it's pretty open, I think. Yeah, it's all right. Just a bit of faster flowing. Yeah, dead trees are just coming now. Alright. It's that triple dead tree that tells you you're here. And then we're going straight ahead. That's our little singles cheating chute down the left there that I might take in the race. Don't take it. But again, from here, it's just where the water goes. I went there yesterday. Nah, it sucks. This is the hardest bit of it right here with the gravel. Yeah, it's fine. Easy. Go left. Did you go there, you think? So these both look kind of hard. This is the log I was worried about, but it's not as bad as it used to be. But I mean, I thought we came this channel to avoid this, but that's okay. Well, this is the bit of a... I don't know if this is where you should come. You guys go straight ahead. This way. Dad was saying about these bushes here, but I mean, I wouldn't be, if you can turn there, then wicked, but I don't think you'll get the double through there. But either way, I think, yeah, you regarding this log here, I wouldn't take that left hand. We're just split just here. Can't go left. Now, I still hold my hat out for that channel at the top on the left. Yeah. And I reckon you guys could easily do it in the double. Yeah. But Dad's already decided, or he thinks it's too hard. I reckon have a look, yeah. We could even just pull right up where we just paddled, because it's so shallow the whole way up. We could go and just paddle, because we're in the middle of the river here. I can't... This will be slow, and if there are any boats in here, then it'll be just... Yeah, you're probably right down here, because a lot of people walk, obviously the gravel chutes, yeah.
Yeehaw!
Jeez, I let go of my paddle when I got stuck up there, and it floated past me, and I almost missed it, and... Oh, idiot, Terry. Oh. So we'll get a little bit chilly, but I guess, yeah, you're right, we can just walk on the side most of the way. See, this that little bit at the end there with the overhanging log... No, there, that thing. Yeah. If the water gets more powerful, then it will push you under there, and you'll be trying to... It's not very long now, I guess. It only comes out like a foot. But that used to come out halfway across the river, you know? And then you used to be ducking under the goddamn thing, and oh, man. Maybe we carry up here. Worst comes to worst, yeah. Just gets... Sorry? Okay. Looks a little bit deep. Aha. You good? you still want to go. Yeah, no, no, we have to get above where that triple tree. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We can put in, on my little island here, it's possible to put in, you can come on, come up here if you like. Yeah, true, true. Just above this gravel bank is possible to get in there. Yeah, if it's snug, if it doesn't get loose. I reckon I'll get in right here. Oh, hey. Go that side. And then you can chuck the boat to me and then I can pull you in the boat. No, no, where the triple tree is, you turn, but you can get in here and paddle upstream. Super shallow right here. Oh yeah, just go right to the top, into the shallow stuff. I think it's where you can see the water pooning off to the left, right there, yeah. That's right, it's almost right angles, but that's not the hard turn. The hard turn is halfway down. That dead tree is in the middle, almost in the middle, and you kind of got to go around it like an S-bend. But it's in low water like now, you know, if this is a hard bit like it is, then there's so slow that, like, I tell it, grab the tree, there's a big root like this, and I mean, yeah, you're a double, so it's like, you know, double harder to do, but I still think there's tons of space, and you've got plenty of time, so you should be okay here.
Yep. I'll get in.
You might have to go just behind the dead tree itself, because I don't know if there's any eddy. It's all pretty fast flowing there, but you know, just keep it straight. I'll be up just behind you. Yeah, this is see, this is the bed of water, but I went there and it's crap entry. But here's more water. But try do that. And so, that's the first of about 20 down there. Not a, you know, like 3 or 4 of them. Yeah, sure, great, but. You know, like a dozen or more? No, that's stupid.
It's the triple tree there. Is that the one Dad calls, or you guys call it?
Decision tree, dead tree decisions. So I made up the dead tree decision name because there's all the dead trees here. So you recognise, oh crap, I'm coming to all the dead trees. I'm going to make a decision here. Ah. But Dave Tuffling actually chopped the trees down in this chute here, so that's Dave's chute or some name that, Dave's tunnel, I think Pat was calling it. But triple tree, yeah, this dead tree. Dad will call it dead. Absolutely. Done. Book. little upstream. Yep. Well, the chute itself, yeah. You're gonna turn pretty early. You'll start to see the dead trees from a little while away. Yeah, chuck into that eddy, I'll come in just next to you and do the same thing. Yeah, that's a good eddy, isn't it? Yeah. Okay. So, I mean, it's open enough, but you'll see the dead tree halfway down. Once you're at that dead tree, it's like home and hose-ish.
Well, you need to turn the corner, so it's slow through here.
Totally. It's the one right in front that you can see down there. Oh, there's a log right here. I'd cut the corner there. Well, yeah, you see it there underwater. I imagine you'll be taking it like late like that, exactly like you just did, yeah. We're turning right here. Again, tons of time, so it looks tight, but you've got tons of time. Just come in here backpedaling with the nose in the correct position. And then you want to duck and turn left. Stay ducked. Don't come up like I did. There's two logs. Turn left. Slow down. Yeah, you can take it real slow. The water goes. But then left, this is it. This is the last hard bit. Left side. Plenty of room, but left side. And that's it. You're good. You gotta trust the water to pull you around, don't you? In the dead tree part itself. And now we empty out back to where we stopped just before. Straight, yep. Yep. There's the big log there, yeah. The nose has a good opportunity to go the wrong way in a few places, doesn't it? Push the log off on the side, but that's, yeah, the log won't be a problem. Now here's the ford. I was over there yesterday. Is that at least? Same here, yeah. The other one empties into this one. Usually you want to cut to the far left when you get to the ford, but you're already at the far left. Come here. Apostles, yep. It's the top of the Apostles Pool here. These are those little branches that get in your way. Oh yeah, you got to cut left here, so in the double you might even be going around there, but if you just remember to cut left, go around that thing. Dad knows that thing. He might have gone the other way. He might go the other way next time. You do have a fair bit of time, and then that one that you're going to hit there, that's not a bad overhang, so, you know, if you stuff it up, it's not much, and you can probably jump it pretty easily, look like. Absolute. Well, in point four, you can't jump it, and you have to go around the thing, and oh, that's, yeah. The first time I came down here, that was a problem one. Alrighty, go pump. Yeah, we're at the Apostles Pool now. There's just a little, there used to be a tea tree around the corner here, but it's gone now. So we're just in the pool now. You'll see dead trees when you actually get to the chute itself. Two dead tree areas, the dead tree decision up there and then the dead trees in Apostles. Still almost broke an hour to our Apostles here. Only 1:05. Oh, yeah? Oh, cool. I think they're the ones that come and steal our Banksias from the front garden. Every so often. So you come around the corner here and you see the dead trees and you know you're just above Apostles. And you hear the roar. I take off my sunnies now. No good in white water. Okay. The Apostles we take about a meter from the rock that's out of the water. Not right next to it, but next to the rock that's next to it. So the rocks next to it will be just under the water and you'll scrape them if you hit today. Or just miss those. The spectator. Hey. Ooh. Yee-hee! think he'll take, he'll probably take too long. I asked him the other day and he says, oh no, you'll be there in 2 minutes, you know, in a minute, yeah. Just in case, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. Exactly, yeah, yeah. Hopefully not from in the water. For me or you. Yeah, it wouldn't be a thing, yeah. But I guess the tip is turn early, like come around that corner, duck the tree, and then rip a rudder stroke in, and then start paddling, and just go through the main chute, the drop while paddling, while forwards momentum, while power, yeah. And then obviously brace where you need to brace, yeah. That was my big foo-foo yesterday. See if I remember how to do that. Yeah. And if you do find yourself on the outside there, ride the wave down, exactly. Lean downstream, don't try and suddenly change direction or suddenly do anything. And don't do giant sweep strokes like I did. Oh, and make sure you don't eddy out at the top, just slow down as much as you need to with rudder strokes. Just keep ruddering the whole time, you know. Yep, this is it. No, you wait up here, yeah. That's what I mean. Don't eddy out down the bottom there. You want to cut the corner as much as possible. Yeah, yeah. Alrighty. Cut those corners. Yeehaw! That corner. Oh yeah. Yeah boy! Yeah. Make it look easy. Spin out as soon as you can. Left. Oh yeah, you got it. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. I'll grab that same one because it's easier to carry out from. Oh. Yeah, yeah, that's right. You came straight down the middle and I was worried you were too far left and like you just didn't matter, you know? There's a thing coming, yeah. I'll just go next to you here and put a little water. Yeah, milk. Perfect. Yeah, yeah. It's like a, you know, like a 2 minute walk, I think, from the car, so you have to kind of be here, or in, you know, your car has to be here already. So let me jump off your boat for a second. Okay. Blub, blub, blub. There we go. Cheers. Jeez, you didn't, like, you were stable as hell the whole way down. I was expecting you to go, whoop, da, dip, da, kind of thing. Like, there was no big side, whoa, kind of moment there. Like, no, must have been.
I just had the bridge to the rapids.
So oh, yeah. And you do the correct stroke and you go, oh yeah, that's what happens. Yeah, yeah, you know, yeah. Anticipating what you do how what you do affects where you're going and what you're doing there. Alrighty, well, successful paddle today. Thanks, bro. Video over.